Also, go ahead and give you guys a view of my screen too, because I know that there are some folk who use Clip Studio Paint but are curious about how I structure my shit, so I'll go ahead and show that. Also gonna make one more tweak. Now you guys can see what I see. Have you ever tried Fire Opalka in the past? I have tried Fire Opalka. Just a little bit though, not enough to like, I haven't finished any pieces in it, and just the UI wasn't for me, and also I was coming from Psy and stuff, so. How Cammy is so cute on this. Sweet girl. What I like to do when I'm gonna prep something for a render is separate all of the different local colors together. Or separate them from each other. So like this is the head, this is the body, this is the shirt. And so if I do need to render them individually, I can just be like, okay, well, I just need this layer. And it's just one layer that I'm dealing with. There is a point where I did start having to need to order and group my layers reasonably well, or else I'll just get lost. So I love how the scope is rendered in VR chat. The way it's rendered in my reference over here is a little more cartoony. But this is a lot more realistic because it is like it is a lens. But I'll keep this blue for now, so I know it's the scope. But I just have my arms left, I think. Welcome back! You're catching the final part of the stream where I render something in real time. It just took me a while to sketch shit out, but I do have a Keller I want to render. He's so fine. He's so sexy. This is Caliber! The artist Turbo Sector is going to debut the 3D model soon in VR chat. And I wanted to take a screenshot of them in a beach setting, which is super cute. And I'm gonna reference this and show how, like, do like a small little demonstration of how, like, metal interacts with really bright environments. You see how, like, the ground is reflecting onto his hands and stuff. He's actually, like, you know, his hands and stuff are silver, right? But because of how reflective it is, it's reflecting a lot of the background. So I wanted to demonstrate that. It's gonna be pretty fucking baller. And then I'll be ending stream because I've been streaming for a bit, but it's been a good stream. It was, you know, I got over a lot. I went over a lot of fundamentals mostly. And the thing is with fundamentals, it's very important to know those before bending the rules to how you, how to fit your taste, essentially. Yeah, I've been doing this for a bit. We're almost done, though. There we go. I just wanted to demonstrate this one real quick. Strawberry lemonade lips make a nigga blood pressure go drip drip drip. Bows is the devil like 666. Bows is the devil like 666. When I got you on my mind, ain't no room for a thought. When you laying on my chest, ain't no room for my heart. Girl, you know we wasting time. This is gonna be a lot of fun though. I'm gonna put a little beach in the background. A really shitty beach, but it's gonna be a beach nonetheless. My cartoony background beach is what I'm gonna draw right now. Oh no! Oh no, it's gonna turn everything blue! Ah! Gradient background. We love a gradient background. The focus isn't the background in this. It's gonna be, you know, not the background. Draw a palm tree in the back. If she's selling, she working, no lying, the price right, no flirting, I'm buying. Same day, airfare, I'm flying. Love trappers, love rappers, love diamonds. I got it, I give it, come get it. Birkin bags, bad bitches, come with it. City girls, come count up my digits. Can't break them, can't shake them, I live it. I ain't, I robot, I never, I only. Big foreigns, I pedal. She chases, speed racer, daredevil. IDK, king push, it's level, yeah. This is cute. The strawberry lemonade lips make a nigga blood pressure go drip drip drip. Bad hoes is the devil like 666. Bad hoes is the devil like 666. When I got you on my mind, ain't no room for a thought. When you layin' on my chest, ain't no room for my heart. Girl, you know we wasting time. Yeah, we're gonna try to go for that sunny vibe. It's cute. She wanna lock lips, I just put over, made her stop pit inside of my whip. When I'm driving, it's called a cockpit. Obvious if she ride with a kitty, she giving knowledge. Alright, that's cute. Alright, and now I'm going to turn this a little darker. There's a color on the right, but we're gonna ignore him for now. That's not what the sketch I ended up wanting to work on. Now why is he so scary looking? Oh my god, color. Buddy, it's okay. There we go. Yay! We have a light background now. I'm gonna put color on his own canvas. There it goes. There you go, Keller. You get your own space. See ya. And we're gonna render this out. Mm-hmm. background. Oh, there we go. Colors. Alright. And if anyone has any questions while I'm working on this, before I end, feel free to ask them. I'll be watching chat. Like, if there's any questions about, like, my process here, because I am showing my tablet screen this time around, because I'm going to cut this up later and show people, like, what the fuck I do. And I'm basically studying from this VR chat photo, because, like, I can already see, like, blue from the sky hitting, like, the white of his, like, collar here. So, like, I'll have to watch about to catch up. Yeah, no worries. But this specular blue hair is, like, really cool. The blue hitting his chest, you know, things like that. Like, there's a lot of information here that I definitely want to convey. See if I can put that in my render. It'll be a challenge to myself. I guess if I can do it. Like, I want to say that I can pull this off. So let's see. Let's see if I can do it. Fox snacks! Yes! And if, as you can tell here, I'm not even really using a multiply tool, I'm just applying color liberally and matching the photo. A lot of my quicker renders will only be done on one layer, and I just kind of guess colors, you know? Here, I'm gonna do one of the things I taught on stream earlier. Oh, that's cool. That looks good. Okay. And then what I really like about the head is that, like, it's so shiny. It's taking up light from all over the place. And it's because it's a very glossy finish, so I'll demonstrate that right now. I'm gonna actually add a spot black. So a lot of how my art style has developed over time is, like, mixing in these inks with the final render, because this is what also sells glossiness too, and that's how I kind of make it a little more, like, cartoony, comic booky, I guess, if I have to describe it. And then I'll even go over this too, and like, I really love how the, his scope head catches so much of the blue sky. Like, that's so pretty. Thank you. I think it's a subject I'm lacking in, I know. Yeah, it takes a lot of just, like, photo study. I did a lot of photo study in college. Like, that was a mandatory part of the learning. I was like, oh, this seems pretty interesting if I wanted to study maybe robots. And I could do the same, I can apply the same, like, kind of study technique, essentially. Because all of this is really just observational skills, really. I'm really excited to render his neck, though. Look how his neck captures the blue of the sky. But you can see also the sand, too. Like, it really is a mirror. It's mirroring the trees. You can see the tree line here. You can see the tree line. You can see the sand and stuff. Like, it's really interesting to study. Yeah, very reflective. His arms are also very reflective, too. And what's cool is that, like, the neck is warping it. So, like, the lines of his neck, if you look in his concept art... Here, now we're gonna have three windows. So, if you look at his concept art, it is like a warped sort of design. It curves around his neck. Yeah, right here. This is a good example right here. It curves, and you can tell that curve. It's implied with the warping of the light around his neck. So, that's so fucking cool. The fact that... And this is rendered in a VR chat, which is all, you know, the computer does all the rendering for you. The fact that it captured that detail and did it with such accuracy, fucking awesome. I nearly need to get a VR chat model. Cameo needs to be in VR chat. This is not debatable. I need to talk to some people. I need to save money. Very chrome looking, yes. Love this look for him. Oh my god, I think Caliber's awake. I think Turbo's awake. Wait, hold up. Let me render the eye, because I really want to study how his scope is rendered in VR chat, in realistic lighting. Because this is a realistic lighting scenario. I love how dark the scope is. So there's like, it's like dark on the outside and blue on the inside, I think. You know. I love this design so much. And look how much of the sand color is his scope is like capturing. His scope is completely dark, by the way. Like it's like a dull sort of gray, but it's capturing all of the outside light. Because the sand is so fucking bright, it's bouncing everywhere. Here, let me use a red. Yeah, this sand is fucking everywhere because it's reflecting so brightly. So you can see it in his chest, his eye, his neck. Ugh. Even his hands, like, you see these reflections in these hands? Yep. All of that is the sand. So fucking cool. Hi, Chadwick, I'm still streaming. I'm almost done, but I think Turbo's awake. I really need to send a work in progress of this because it's coming out so cute. Oh my god. Yes, holy shit. Oh my god. I am so excited to render this. I'm not gonna lie. Let me go ahead. So what I like to do when I paint, I have all of these layers assigned to all the colors that I'm using, right? But then I go in and I just paint on top of it. Like I nothing is sacred to me. And the seeing as it's on another layer, I can do that. So there's no skin off my back, honestly. So let's go ahead and get this head rendered out, and then I'm gonna throw Turbo a link. What I like about using harsh edges like this too is that you can use this to essentially sculpt whatever machine or metallic surface you're doing. Like, what I like about rendering robots is that I can use harsh edges like this. I'm straight up just using a pen tool. Like, this is just the pen tool I'm using. But I'm able to carve out this very specific shape of the lens. So, like, you know, just without really any worry. Because I'm just out here trying to get the shape of the scope. Turbo might be joining, which is very exciting. I want them to talk about VR chat at me because I love learning about VR chat from Turbo. One thing I'm gonna do, one trick that I've learned for doing screen reflections on like visors and stuff is just take the background and paste it, or take whatever's in front of the character and paste it on their face, and you have like an instant fucking reflection. It works! It gets the job done! Oh, the scope is so pretty. I got rid of a layer on accident. I think I may have. There we go. Let's go. No worries. Have a good night. Thank you for joining. Yeah, I'm liking how this is coming out too. Caliber the skank with his tits out. Cover them up, slut! See how his chest is also catching the fucking sand too, because they're so fucking massive. His knockers are just so big! These are gonna be the nicest rendered tits I've ever done. Also, welcome! Hello! When do you come to realize that you're under my skin? For me to hide from your mother. Don't you see? He got some hella knockers. Oh my god. Seeing how the game renders him in 3D will also help me understand how to render his vest in the future, because I do get commissioned caliber quite often. So I might as well get a handle on how he renders in actuality. I am very much enjoying this though. My silence, silence be damned, you know. This man is so hot. They got biddies. I'm obsessed with this song, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna render his arms. This is where it's gonna get fucking wicked wild. Because his arms have very specific things going on in them. This left hand here is a good example of that. I have to do a spot black first. Spot blacks just basically tell me where the horizon line is in the reflections. This is Left Hand Free by Lido. Lido did a remix of this song. You might be familiar if you listen to Alt-J at all. Problem, King. I find that in order to sell Chrome, you really do need to have some harsh, like, you know, horizon lines built into the render before you even start dealing with color. Because then you can... I'll use this one as an example. This is such an obvious, like... This is the sky, and then that's the that's the ground, and then the middle part is the horizon line. That looked like a penis, but don't look at me. The sky. This is the sky. That's sand. And then that's, horizon. The horizon line, so... And it's reflected in every single, like, I have to wrap it around his joints realistically. And this is a sketch, so it's gonna be look kind of off until I can, like, render over it, but... All my robots so far got mats or surfaces, so I'm gonna make another one to apply these tips. Oh yeah, just make a robot that's like super fucking shiny. The Keller is my robot for that, so. I'm trying to apply the same kind of thing happening to Caliber's scope here onto Cameo's lens as well. Because she's also a little, she's got a little camera head, lens looking situation, so. Yes, make a shiny robot with me, guys! This shit is so fun when you figure out the fundamentals of it. Oh, Cameo's so cute. Leggies. She's like attached to his arm like a watch. So cute. Dog, I swear I'm a living pump fake because my guy, good God, I've been a sucker since Madonna, and that's real Nirvana. Well, facts on facts, I've been blessed. I don't clap, I depress. If it don't slap, I hit next. White on black, that's my ex. Full disclosure, that's been over since I got my high school diploma. But my point is, your boy was good up until Corona. Case one, yeah. Hey to Hollywood, what's up? Got my body good, yeah. Hands up on the hill, gas up in the wheel, coffee with a smile. New boy kind of brown, and I'm known to pull it down. Can't nobody tell me nothing, no. Wait, what you mean stay at home? All I've been waiting for is somewhere I'll never go. Damn, I bought a new cologne. Well, lucky for me, I won't be lonely. Cause you're so, so sweet. Hey, what's your only fans? Cameras is a little difficult to figure out because I'm not using a reference for her, so I'm just like, I'm gonna wing this shit. He's a roughly look like Cameo, that's all. and it looks a little more natural. Yeah, looks nice. And now his legs are next. That's gonna be fun. Follow the same method as the rest of it. Blue on one of these sides. We're gonna add. Where is this actually? There we go. There we go. Just goes to show, with just a couple colors, you can sell chrome pretty easily. We love cash shadows in this house, let me tell you. Love me a cash shadow. And I'm gonna add some more of that nice, sort of tan color onto the edge of his scope here. My layer system right now is a little messy just because this is just a sketch, technically. But here we are. A cast shadow is when an object that is closer to a surface, as you get further away from it, as an object gets further away from the surface, the shadow is not as harsh. I'll show you a really quick example. So when you have, I'm gonna do a sphere in the ground. So when a sphere is like right next to the surface, but not necessarily touching it, the shadow is very harsh. The shadow is very harsh when it's sitting right on the surface, right? But the further away it gets, the softer the shadow gets. So I'll show you. So this little like shadowed part here. I usually like to add a gradient towards the end of the shadow to kind of give it some, you know, variation. And then a more advanced cast shadow would be something like in his vest right here, like I was saying before. Let's see, where is this? Here we go. So right here on his vest, I demonstrated by, so towards the closest part of his chest on the top there, it gets a little darker, but as it gets further away, it gets lighter, and it gets a little more diffused. Diffused being, say I took this little corner sphere, and it diffuses the further away from the object it is, so it diffuses towards the end here. And then as it gets closer to the object, the shadow gets sharper. Sharper. And then softer. That's generally the rule of thumb when using cast shadows. Cast shadows can make pieces really pop just because they add this very like harsh gradient of dark to light, you know? But that's how I use them at least. It's not perfect in my pieces just because I'm simplifying the shit out of these things, but cast shadows are really fun. And when you establish sort of like, so I'm gonna show you guys the full piece here. Oh, it's looking so pretty! Caliber's looking so pretty! Just copying and establishing, okay, the horizon line, like I was mentioning before, using his hand as a demonstration. The sky, horizon, and sand, ground, reflection is reflected all across him. So it's in every single part of him that's shiny, even in his neck. I was explaining that earlier too. This part is, I'm obsessed with this. That looks so cool, and I'm gonna try to render it out a little further up here. But other than that, I mean, you know, I could make this even shinier. You know, I'll show you what I mean. Let me fix his head real quick, because his head can actually be way shinier. I'll show you. So following the same rule of thumb, I'm gonna add the sand texture. There we go. Horizon, and then on the top of the head of the scope here, we're gonna add that blue. like just kind of erase a little bit. So that's gonna be basically reflected throughout the entire scope. So I'm just gonna paint that in, I think. You can even see a little bit of that horizon texture on the very tiny ridges of his scope, which is, that's a crazy amount of detail and can only be, you know, very quickly rendered by a computer, you know? I could not sit here, and if you ask me here, hey, make a 2D animation of caliber in 2D, and you have to make all the reflections match, and I'm like, I'm crying. Don't make me do that. I'm kind of getting a second wind here, just being able to look at this progress as I go. This is very good study practice, though. I'm really digging this. It's such a small detail too. Like if I removed this little reflection, like it would suddenly become matte, you know? Because without these reflections on his head, he would just have a matte face, you know? Thank you, Gizmo. I'm really happy with how this is coming out too. I can even add a little bit of the green too, like just tiny bits of green, because their horizon does have like green. Caliber being suns out tits for real. Of course! This is the kind of character he is! This is Caliber we're talking about, dude. Love to see it, honestly. I'm happy to paint this man. He's so fun. What I want to do is add screen reflections for his little sort of coat flaps, I guess, because technically these glow, but it's not as intense because we have a global illumination, which is the fucking sun. The sun is so bright! So when a robot that has glowy bits like him goes outside, the glowy bits aren't as pronounced. I mean, you can't really, you know, I can't compete with that. Oh, looks like we got some. Oh, this looks so good, Posey. Oh, I'm gonna share on screen. I love, 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 love how shiny this came out. Oh, that looks awesome. Yes, that's how we do the shiny thing. Here we are. Yeah, that reads very well. Good job. Especially on like cylinders and stuff. Cylinders is how I learned, personally. Awesome job. Yeah, fuck yeah. If anyone is drawing metal right now, if anyone has things they've done that because they followed my stream at any point and you want to show me, I want to see that shit. Gamers, how does this work? What the fuck is that? What the Chadwick, what the fuck are you working on? What is this? Chadwick? Wow, this is so good! Chadwick! Wow, this looks really professional. Holy shit. Can I show off my boyfriend's homework? Because it looks cute. Oh, yes, be flustered! I think this looks cute! Look at the colors! Hey, hi, I'm showing your homework on stream. It's so pretty. I can't help it. Anyway, good job. Keep going. This looks really pretty. I love the rover so much. Look at him go. Let's see. I think the green is really, really bright. I'm not so much worried about it being cluttered. I mean, if you're trying to fit this amount of information, then that might be okay. Like this looks good. I like this bottom part right here. I think the green can be a little more yellow. And I'm gonna help you find a green I'm talking about here. Let me show you. And it's so green. Sorry, guys. It's 46 by 36 inches, because then that's perfect. That's kind of great. I think this, if it's gonna be at that size, I don't think the size will be too bad. Sorry guys for splashing green at you. Yeah, I was thinking this green can be a little more yellow. I'll show you. So I was thinking like maybe. Or maybe you can even make it a little darker, because it is really bright. I'm trying to see if I can find. Yeah, I like that. This is a good green. Like, it's a little more. I'm following the color story of the other colors. It's a little more muted. I'll screenshot it to you. Yeah, if it's gonna be at that size, I think that should be okay. I've worked with posters a lot, so it's kind of a hard say. It is a really big poster, after all. My worry is maybe this part is really small. Because I know that you're trying to follow a good, like, kind of, like, shape story here. Like, I like this. This is great. And also, I'm worried about this purple. This purple might not print properly if it's going to be printed. You might want to make that, like, yellow or white. Purple prints like shit! It prints like shit! You don't care about that part? Okay. If it's a part you don't care about, fuck it. You haven't seen CMYK already? The purple. Oh, I'm worried about the purple. The purple might come out really dark. The brand is purple. Yeah, fuck it. They get it like that then. Okay, yeah. Fuck it. They get to have that. If their shit is purple, it'll read just fine. It just might be a little dark. No changing that. It'll look really good printed. Like, the design is really good. But yeah, other than that green, and maybe this part is the only cluttered part, personally. Might make it blue TM. Ooh, blue would be really pretty. Yeah, this is well spaced. Yeah, these are fine. I think maybe for these two, you might want to bold them. Bold the words in the objectives. Sent you the green in Discord. Nice, that's a good green! Sexy green! Like that! I like that green! I'm out here helping my boyfriend with his work here on stream. Very fun, very cool. I love design. Graphic design is my passion! It's both our passions. We're out here. Anyway, I want to go back to painting. Unless you got some more updates for me. Graphic design is so good because then you're able to implement it into your art. Yes! Oh my god! I've shown the map that me and my partner worked on. I might show it again. It really is a great synthesis of good art and good UI design. You got those two things, you can make a video game. I'm telling you guys. I've seen some artworks where the art is phenomenal, but the graphic design is lacking, to say the least, so it really hurts the work. Yes, the map again! we get to see if I have to, if I end up showing the map at least once per stream, just because I really like this map. Let's see. Okay, where the fuck did I put this map? Okay, so this is the original map. Open, bitch! There we go. So this is the original map that my partner, Chatter made. Me cooking for Providence. Jesus! God fucking damn it, Turbo! and I'll show you guys the edited map that I did. I added UI design mostly to explain each planet in Return Zero's world. I'm making a wiki because I have way so much world building that it takes hours to explain anything, and I'm like, this is becoming a problem! So let me find this fucking map that I'm really proud of. The most powerful map. There it is. My magnum opus. My world building magnum opus is this fucking map. Okay, there you go. Oh no! That's homework! There you go. I need my computer to actually copy stuff. Yes! My sexy, sexy map! Love this map. I added all the words and shit. All of that UI design on that is me. I just put it on top of the art. And, you know, it's very simple. It's nothing special. It's a couple lines, a nice readable format, you know? Big font. That's all you need. Shit. And it explains, like, you know, each planet, what the sun does, Providence, where the fuck he at. Where the fuck Cameo at? I haven't figured that out yet. I think she's just floating around trying not to get beat up, you know? Well, yeah, I really like this map. It's, my favorite. Let's see. Oh, that's so nice. That was a good-ass art in my group chat right now. Okay, I'm gonna go back to painting. There it is. I love this photo so much. I've basically stared at this photo for like 2 hours just studying it. That's what I do when I do art study. I just like paint on top of the fucking, you know. up a little bit. The sniper. Oh, no fucking way. This is voice acted by the actual voice actors? Wait, hold up. We need to watch this.
If I forgot to mention it before now, you snipers are the worst people on the planet.
Oh!
A sniper? He was a sadist. There's a difference. Snipers don't muck around with gut shots and monologues. We just take the shot.
Yes. You're a credit to the institution of shooting people from far away. Enjoyed torturing him first, by the way.
Yeah, well, next time speak up before I blow his head off. Take one of them cigs.
Oh, they're so hot. These two are so gay. So, did you saw the medic? There's a dem medic, like a demo man one. I need that.
I wonder where the others are.
Yes, I was wondering the same thing, except about your pants and when you'll be putting some on.
I'm not exactly sneaking through a pants store. You do know what people do in their pants when they die, right?
Yes, I'm aware. It would still be preferable.
Give us your coat.
I said, give us your. I heard exactly what you said. This is a $10,000 custom tailored Louis Crabmarché jacket.
Crabmarché!
Shoot microfarm in Tuscany from a secret pattern passed down by monk tailors since the 7th century. I will let you use it as an adult diaper when you pry it off my cold, dead body.
Oh my fucking god, this is so good. This is so fucking good. Holy shit. Are they just, like, bugging them on TikTok or something? Like, well, how the fuck did we get this? Oh, this is so good. Love that for us, guys. We truly are living. Oh, I get to play my favorite... my favorite Tim Pola song. So the background is completely isolated from my foreground. This is the shit I live for. Background optional. I don't need the background. The background is literally stuck on him. because we took the method of, like, you know, rendering out the background onto his sexy robot body. So here we are. This is what you get when you when you keep your background in mind when you render. It's pretty magical. I'm not gonna lie. I love rendering. Oh my god, you found the Demo Man one. Yes! Holy shit. Okay, this is very important. I love Demo Man.
W for the hydrogen peroxide?
Here you go.
Danke. This won't take a moment.
Oh, I love Medic's voice so much.
I always wondered. You can bring a man back to life. Why can't you grow me another eye? Well,
of course I can. The procedure is quite simple, really.
What? You mean to tell me all these years you could put me eye back anytime you bloody liked?
Could have? My friend, I've given you your eye back at least 8 times. And every time it functions normally, until Halloween night, at which point it grows bat wings and but a giant, your eye, a Dracula, your eye, a brain in a jar, your eye.
This is so good.
Becky,
in time and try to become our parents.
Dude, Medic's voice actor killed that! Holy shit! Finally, some of the TF2 comics are pure gold. I'm happy these comic dubs are a thing. Oh, I know. No worries. Thank you for dropping by again, Chadwick. Let me know when you get home. God. God, I love TF2. I want a TF2 renaissance, guys. I want TF2 back on the map. Okay? I am done pining over the lack of TF2. I need it to come back. Because a lot of my art study mostly came from TF2. Have you seen TF2's concept art? I've been spamming it in my server for a little bit, but let me tell you, they cracked the code on how to simplify a human form with shapes. I don't know how they did it, but it's some magic shit. This piece is almost done. They're just out here cleaning up the... I don't even know if we want a background on him. I guess we'll have a background as a treat, right? You know, background as a treat situation. Just clean it up a little bit. I do like the sort of like asymmetrical look of this. So I'll try to keep that intact, I think. That's cute. Okay. We're just cleaning up the background. This will basically be done. This, the magic shot comes in next right here. I'm gonna show you my favorite part of the rendering process, which is the post-processing. Post-processing being anything added to the drawing after you've done the the initial stint of rendering, which is basically everything I did just now. we're gonna start moving this around, turning this into a composition that I can post on the internet. And then we're gonna fuck around with the background a little bit. Oh yeah, this is super pretty. We're gonna add the shiny shit, guys. This is gonna be fun. This is probably my favorite part. Y'all know me. This is where all like the texturing of the metal comes in. I always do that shit last because this is additional detail that doesn't necessarily need to be added unless you want to add that extra polish. So we're gonna be doing that and then posting it. Shiny time. Oh, I love this song. Fuck yeah. We can register this song. Yeah, this is my favorite part of the rendering process because I love making shit shiny. God, he's so hot! This man is so hot! Oh my god. A lot of my art is very exaggerated shiny shit, so this is the shit I live for. Turbo's gonna lose their fucking mind. They don't know exactly how ham I'm going right now, but I'm going really fucking ham. I think this might be done. It's hard for artists to kind of, especially for me, I say this, an artist, I have a hard time determining when a piece is done, but I feel like this doesn't need more, you know? Like, I can gradient map the shit out of this and see what else I can come up with, but this is pretty much done. Not bad for, like, a couple hours, you know? Start to finish, it looks pretty good. I'm gonna blur this out a little more. Oh, yeah. Oh, this looks so cinematic. I love that. It's definitely a blur. Yeah, this color's super sassy, dude. analysis done. The additional last part I was talking about was the gradient map thing, and I'll show you what that looks like when applied to a piece. So I grab it, tonal correction gradient map, and I've got it in black and white now. Now we can, a dialog box will pop up, and now I can choose some colors. I want to add a gradient map that will add a little bit of visual interest. Ooh, that is so rainbow. Good God. Give me some more orange. Ooh, that's pretty. Ooh, that's pretty. Green. Oh, that one's pretty. That one's pretty! Oh my God, this one's so pretty. Okay. So, what I like to do is change up the blending mode. So it like changes the, if I wanted to make that more pink, I could, but I feel like that might be a little intense. Oh, that's so orange. Oh, that's so pretty! Oh my God! Oh, that's so pretty. This is what I mean by gradient maps are kind of baller. Because, like, you can find little things that you wouldn't be able to do if you had not, you know, taken the time to separate everything, and then if you wanted to change something really quickly, then it's like you need to be able to have those layers on hand. It gets really messy. So I just like to take the extra time to make sure all my layers are kind of in order enough so I can know where things are. That's fucking pretty. I really love the purple in this, but that's so curious. Yeah, some things you can only find in a gradient map, guys. Ooh, the saturation's pretty. Saturation's a goofy. It made his titties more orange. Oh, that's so pretty, though. I might keep some of that blue. What I like to do, if I like a certain filter, I'll keep it, but then I'll erase parts of it. Let's see. Because I love how saturated everything is right now, but I'm just gonna remove the parts I don't want so saturated. Oh, that's pretty. That's super pretty. Okay, he's getting a little lost in the sauce over here. Get over it. I'm adding some blue reflections too, because his little collar here glows. This is so cute. Okay, this is done now. I know I said that like 15 minutes ago, but this is actually done. Alright. Thank you everyone for coming to this very variety, but mostly a tutorial stream on how to render metal. I will start stitching parts of this out for YouTube and shit like that.